scheiß Nigga. Huh? Most people don't actually believe this, but then before I was a trapper, I was likely a conscious rapper. And with the time and age that we were going into, someone just told me to slow it down, and eventually I did slow it down, and then yeah, it just stick. I felt like I felt comfortable in this tempo of music, and yeah, I just went with it. With the sound of trap, there's a lot of trap genres. Like, you get trap music, and under trap music, you can get ghetto trap, gospel trap, country trap, like Lil Nas, you know what I'm saying? So with my sound of trap, I try to keep it original, like the original trap sound. So I don't try and diversify myself away too much from the trap sound. I just try and keep it as original as possible. With the younger generation, with the kids, one thing that I, as a new wave artist, think that I'm doing to the kids is showing them that even though you're not the best in like school, you know what I'm saying, you might not be the highest in academics or the best sportsman, but if you just follow what you have and the talent that they gave you, and if you just persevere with like the comments of giving up, yeah, the kids are learning to believe in themselves more and yeah, follow their dreams. Follow your dreams. I just pull up cause I got to. In the rap industry in South Africa, I see myself as the hardest trapper. And when that comes to carving my own road, I don't think South Africa has ever had a trapper before, as trap is kind of a new element to music, which differs from hip-hop. It is a form of hip-hop, but it's just a different turn that it took. Bloodsport was actually one. It was me and my friend's idea in high school. We were watching a Jean-Claude Van Damme movie titled Bloodsport. And if you look at Bloodsport, I see my whole life as a Bloodsport, because I see Bloodsport as not letting anyone else. Like, in life, it's about me and where I'm going. And if you're in my way, I'm not gonna let you stand there. I have to move you out the way so I can continue with my path. And for me, that's how most people live today. And that's how I came up with Bloodsport as an idea project. Okay, Bloodsport 1 was special to me because that's when the dream started, and which is why I kept the Bloodsport name going. Because as a rapper that was like releasing music on SoundCloud and not getting any streams, Bloodsport was my first project where I saw growth in myself. And after that, every Bloodsport that I dropped, after I dropped Bloodsport 1, I dropped Bloodsport 2. And Bloodsport 2 was me trying to grow from Bloodsport 1 into a new Vegas in Bloodsport 2. And Bloodsport 3 is me growing again from where I was the previous year into a new character. With I Ain't Got One, we got really good reception because 20,000 in 10 days is pretty good. We just had a lot of marketing, and our marketing team was really good, and the promotion of that song, the methods that we use to promote the song were also a very good method. And I think that's why the reception that it got happened, because if you put in work into a project, you will see the outcome of like the work. I was really happy to see that, because 20,000 in 10 days on SoundCloud in South Africa, that is a lot. It's a lot of people listening to your song at the same time, and going from an artist that used to get 100 plays and thinking, wow, I got 100 plays, to getting 20,000 plays in 10 days was a really big step up. Flexing on your exes, they just met a nigga made it, yeah, I told you I'm on my way. With the new wave, I feel pretty it's like something that's really close to my heart, because when me and Kai, let me just start with Kai. Kai was like my first manager when no one was listening to my music. Kai was that guy, was like, hey, play this man's track, if you get what I'm saying. And then with Kai as well, he wanted to be an influencer. And then the first time the term new wave was like used was an event in like 2015. It was like an event called the new wave, which Kai was a part of. So then seeing that grow from just an event that your friend was part of, and you performing at that event, to now you being a rapper and your friend is like this big influencer in the new wave, which was something that was just a thought once upon a time. Yeah, it makes me happy. That'll be all for the sports scenes. Or we can turn up with Vegas Caesar. Catch me on Instagram at Vegas X Rampage and on SoundCloud at Vegas X Caesar. Wizard. Dope.